guys, welcome back to another Maker Monday here at the Jessamine County Public Library. Today we're going to be talking about our 3D scanner. So this scanner is a great way to take a physical object, whether that be something that's hard to find or something that's broken, and then create a file out of it you can then 3D print. So come with us and we will show you how it works.
Hey everybody, my name is Austin. I work at the Jessamine County Public Library, and today we're going to be working with our HP Sprout, also known as our 3D scanner. I'm going to go in and show you what all you can do with the software and the hardware we provide here, and look forward to it. Alright, so the first thing we're going to start off with is, it's called 3D Capture. You can load it from the desktop, and once you get to the screen, you're going to have your object. You're going to place it perfectly in the center of the mat, in the circle, the green circle there. Once you have it in the circle, you can click the 3D Capture button, and from that point, you can slowly rotate the object with your fingers. You do have to be a little bit slower with it. If you move too fast, it will actually lose tracking on your object. Our HP Sprout doesn't do as good with brighter colors, or darker colors for that matter. So as you see here, once I get towards the bottom where it's kind of a clear, lighter color, it might not capture it as well. Yeah, it's going to keep losing tracking. But for our purposes here, we're going to go ahead and stop right there. Once we get to our next point, you're going to see that the object is now kind of a grayscale. What you're going to do is go in and rotate it. And each time you've got a good portion that is grayscale, you're going to click the camera button, and it's going to apply some color to it. Rotate it around. Rinse and repeat. Click the camera button. Rotate it some more. Looks like this is our last segment on the circular. And then we're going to go to the top. And then kind of from an angle, we're going to angle it, and then we get the color. And from that point, once you have all your color, keep in mind we didn't do the bottom because it's clear. It wasn't going to go on there well to begin with. We're just going to click the check mark. And what that's going to do is finalize. And if you can see, I know you can, but it's really low resolution right there. After it finalizes, it will actually look a little bit better than what it currently looks like. And we'll wait for that to get done. Alright, and after finalizing, you've got a more clear view of what you've scanned. We have a few hiccups in ours, and you can definitely tell at the bottom we weren't able to get it well. But if you can see the bottom, it's not, you know, it's just not good for scanning. Ideally, you'll have something that won't be really bright or really dark for your scans. And then I might have went just a little bit too fast on the scan, and that's why we got a little bit kind of funky stuff going on the side there. But once you're good with that, you're going to export. You can just click save, and then it's going to export as an STL. And then you have an STL file ready to 3D print. Alright, so here we have our scannability matrix. You can find this at the 3D scanner when you come into the library. On our left column here, these are going to be items that are going to be impossible to scan. The software simply won't pick it up. In our middle tier here, we have things that are going to be more difficult to scan. They're going to be items that have grooves or unfinished edges, or really dark items. And then things that are easier are going to be right here on the right column. These are going to be items that are a little bit more simple and will show up easy in the software. And as an example of something that would be kind of not good for our 3D scanner, I've got Lord Vader here. If you can see, when we put him down, the circle turned green because my hand's in there, but the circle won't turn green, and the software simply won't read him. We can even try turning him around on his side. Still not really going to do anything. And that's mostly because this is just a really dark image and it just won't pick up on it. All right. And as an example of something that would be lighter that would also not read well on our 3D scanner, I've got Stitch here. If we put him down here and put him perfectly in the center, standing up, it can't read him. Even if we lay him down on his back, still going to give it problems just simply because if you notice on the screen here, he does actually look a little bit dark. But yeah, just something kind of neutral in color would probably be best for the HP Sprout.
Thank you for tuning in for Maker Monday. I'll see you next time. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and share. Thank you.